Gonna boycott the next movie you're in. Ooh, I hope it's not Iron Man. Oh man, I hope it's not a Marvel movie. Welcome everybody to an episode of AZNN, which is your number one Asian news source on YouTube, or at least top three. I'm gonna be giving my hot takes on hot Asian news all across the world, spanning from America back to Asia to everywhere in between. I'm gonna be talking about Jollibees, Japanese royalty, Taiwanese politicians rapping. We even got stuff about Gwyneth Paltrow. What is going on? Let's talk about it. At the top of the news, we got Jollibees opening up in Times Square and people lined up like it was the craziest Supreme drop. This was a hype release that you did not need a bot for. Jollibees is a Filipino fast food chain that's known across the world for its chicken joy and its surprisingly delicious spaghetti. People were lining up in the rain for over 20 hours just to get fried chicken. To be honest, there's not a lot of other Asian fast food chains making it in America. And probably as a Filipino and even as an Asian person myself, I really didn't expect to see Jollibees make it in Times Square. Times Square is super expensive to open up a business in. And not only that, when you open up there or if you have an ad there, essentially you are arriving to the world. You are letting everybody in the entire world know that you have made it. If a Mos Burger opened up in Times Square, I'm pretty sure all the otakus would be lining up and probably fighting in line like it's Complex Con. Obviously, due to the hype, how much people love Jollibees, clearly, I think they're gonna do okay. So what other Asian fast food chains would you guys like to see open up in Times Square? Let me know in the comments below. Does this news story make me angry? Is it ridiculous or is it important? Well, let me tell you this, it's important. Speaking of Asian countries on the come up, it brings us to Vietnam, where Miss Vietnam has just won Miss Earth. That is a beauty pageant. If you guys haven't been keeping up with your global beauty pageants like I have, Phong Khon Nguyen has just won Miss Earth. So the main reason why she won is that she killed this answer about technology, which she said something along the lines like, well, we have all the technology in the world, but it seems like we're just using it for selfishness
and narcissism.
Honestly, do a lot of people even care about beauty pageants? What does this even mean that Miss Vietnam won? Well, Vietnam, if you guys don't know, has been an emerging market in Asia for many, many years now. It's just reached the point where I have so many Vietnamese friends that are going back and forth a lot more often than their families used to in the past. And it's just become this cool place where it feels like Vietnam is becoming a cultural center now. And that is big. Their country has stabilized. They're doing a lot of manufacturing. And basically, it just seems like it's popping out there. You guys can read about a country's GDP and all the economic terms, but honestly, it's stories like this that go viral that really are the easiest way for people to understand how a country is doing. And Vietnam is coming up. Ja oi, ja oi! Important stamp. I want to take this to Taiwan. The Taipei mayor just released his first trap music video. So the mayor of Taipei, Ko Wen-je, who is also a potential presidential candidate for Taiwan, has just released a music video called Do the Right Thing. Is it an homage to the old Spike Lee film? I don't know, but a strong message it is. He knows that hip hop is such a movement out there that he's just trying to connect to the youth. I'm not gonna lie, he pulled it off a lot better than a whole bunch of other politicians. I've seen politicians in America try to do it, and it just comes off really, really off. But somehow, maybe he played up kind of the old OG Asian gangster vibe, but I thought he looked pretty cool in it. My question is this, in America, could we imagine a presidential candidate also trying to do this and putting out a music video that looks this good? I would probably say not, just because the way hip hop is viewed in this country is a lot different than the way they consume it in Taiwan. I think the association with the streets is much stronger out here than it is out there. How ridiculous is this story? Well, let me tell you this, it's a ridiculously good music video. I mean, I don't know who he got it to do it. They're probably doing MJ116 videos and MC Hot Dog videos too. I mean, he got the vibe down. Shout out to him. Now we're gonna hop from Taiwan to mainland China. China has more tech companies worth at least $1 billion than America does. And these billion-dollar tech companies are called unicorns. Let me know in the comments below what the Chinese word for unicorn is. I need to know. China has 181 startups worth $1 billion. America only has 138. I know that when you think of China, you're not thinking of all these tech companies, but what you have to understand is that they have over 1 billion people, and that market for tech is humongous. Things like DD, which is like the Chinese Uber, you got Luckin Coffee, which is like the Chinese Starbucks. Basically, what a lot of these apps were able to do was they took a lot of inspiration from American apps, but they also threw on their own twist and a whole bunch of new features so that these apps are similar, but even more. Because if you think about it, the Chinese market is so huge, and everybody's on their phones, that when you make an app in China, the market for that app is actually way larger than America. America just based on the sheer amount of people. For a lot of people looking on the outside, including Asians and non-Asians, we tend to think that China is a really throwback country, like squatting to go on the toilet and everything like that. Beyond that though, China's adoption of certain technologies has leapfrogged America. Their cashless payment system, especially through WeChat, is going bonkers. Like, everybody's using it. You can buy street food by just scanning a QR code. You can't even do that in America yet. So as much as there is some old systems and old thinking at play, it's also this weird mixture of new thinking and new adoption. Let me know in the comments below what other technology is being adopted in Asia way before America. That's interesting to know. Important stamp. Now we're hopping from Chinese tech to Chinese pop. JYP Entertainment and Tencent have just teamed up to launch a new boy group. It is a K-pop style C-pop boy group full of 10 to 12 year olds. Their name, Boy Story. This is basically a Korean pop label making a strong play at China, trying to grab the Chinese youth at a young age by giving them a boy group. And when I mean boy, I really mean like boys. Like, these are like kids that are like coming out of their infant stage. Well, growing up, the only kid pop star I knew coming out of Asia was Bae Chow. Everybody has seen the success of Victoria Song or Chris Wu. These are K-pop trained Chinese people make it in China and grab this market and become very, very successful. So of course, everybody wants to get in on the game. And this is the first young little kid group that they've launched. This is like when B2K first dropped. In the comments below, I want to ask you guys what you think. Is Boy Story going to be successful in China? Is this story ridiculous or important? I would say it's a slice of goofiness with a slice of importance. We'll see what happens. Now we're going from Chinese pop to what Gwyneth Paltrow thinks is an old ancient Chinese secret. Yes! Gwyneth Paltrow, Pepper Potts of Iron Man, she has just revealed her love on national TV about what she thinks is an ancient Chinese secret to sexuality. Gwyneth Paltrow went on the Jimmy Kimmel Show representing her company Goop, and she was promoting these jade eggs that women would put them into their private parts to improve their sexual energy. She quote unquote called it an ancient Chinese practice.
Jade egg is an ancient Chinese practice.
Great! Another weird thing has been just labeled Chinese by a white person. Obviously, when she made this claim on TV, people had to fact check her, and as it turns out, researchers have found this is not an ancient Chinese secret. Jade is used for a number of things. It has not been shown to ever been used for that. It just goes to show you that when a culture is branded as weird, esoteric, and very old, that you can say things like this and some people believe it. What does it mean that Gwyneth Paltrow and her company pretty much just said, oh yeah, this is some weird ancient thing. I think it works and it's Chinese. Basically, as Asian people, we gotta come out and defend ourselves because we got rich and powerful white people labeling stuff with our culture. But I will say that Chinese people calling the fermented duck egg a 1,000-year-old egg probably doesn't help prevent the Gwyneths of the world from saying stuff like that. But honestly, if anybody's gonna do it, it might as well be us. This is the first story to hit the angry meter. So Gwyneth Paltrow, for saying that, I'ma hit you with the angry emoji. And I'm gonna boycott the next movie you're in. Ooh, I hope it's not Iron Man. Oh man, I hope it's not a Marvel movie. Now we're moving on from China to Japan. A Japanese princess in Japan has just given up her royal status forever by marrying a commoner, AKA a regular Japanese dude. If you guys didn't know, Japan still has an emperor, and that means they do have a royal family. So this Princess Ayako is actually the youngest daughter of the cousin of the current emperor of Japan. She is in the royal family, or was in the royal family. She may not be royalty anymore, but her hair during her wedding day was pretty lit. It looked like something out of Star Wars. When we think of Japan, a lot of the time you're thinking of robots and Tokyo and conveyor belt sushi and all of this crazy stuff, but they've managed to find this balance between modern society and tradition. And shout out to that guy for nabbing himself a sugar mama. And I also want to point out these new fashionable high-end samurai-inspired Japanese robes that are really popular right now. Someone has also done a similar thing out of Shanghai called Shanghai Tang, where you're pretty much taking old tradition but flipping it in a modern way and pretty much making it cool. Let me know in the comments below other ways that an Asian culture has balanced modern society in with tradition. Now we're gonna take it from traditionally Asian-inspired robes to Asian-American-inspired Halloween costumes. If you guys were Asian on Instagram during Halloween, you will have seen so many crazy rich Asian outfits. They were imitating Awkwafina, Henry, they did Ronnie, they did Jimmy. Everybody had an outfit. Another popular costume was dressing up as comedian Ali Wong. This was the first time in my life that I've seen this number of people dress up as Asian characters in big movies. Crazy Rich Asians was a blockbuster hit. So if anybody asks you who you're dressing up as, you could be like, oh, did you see the movie Crazy Rich Asians? It's only like the top highest grossing rom-com of all time. This is the first time that Asians really felt comfortable dressing up as Asian characters because there were so many popular ones this season. Because these were popular characters in America, whether they're from Crazy Rich Asians or Ali Wong or To All the Boys I Loved Before, whatever it was, basically these were validated by the American mainstream, and that's why Asians feel more comfortable dressing up as them. If it's an Asian niche character, you're gonna roll to a Halloween party or get seen by other people and gonna have no idea what you're dressed up as. Plus, these characters were something you could be proud about. Ali Wong, super funny, and then of course, all the representation in CRA is generally pretty good, so you could feel good about it. It was good to see Asians dress up as Asians without having to feel so Asian. Usually cultural Halloween costumes can be problematic, but in this case, it was progress. Were there any non-Asians dressing up as Asian characters this Halloween? If you guys know of any, tag me on Instagram. I wanna see them. All right, everybody, thank you so much for watching that episode of AZNN. And yes, your number one Asian news source on YouTube, at least top three. All right, everybody, in the comments below, let me know if you like this series, if it's helpful, and what other news articles I should include. Go ahead and respond to all those questions that I pose throughout this video. Those are call to actions. They're not rhetorical questions, so go for it. I love to see your comments on this series because I feel like it's like a whole discussion of people talking about the news and not just me. AZNN, pop culture news with heavy takeaway. Their name, Boy Story.
That's great.
Their name is Boy Story.